In this video, we're going to practice simplifying algebraic expressions. Let's take a couple of examples. So, let's say we were asked to simplify2x plus 3 minus 4 times the quantity x minus 5. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to note that because we don't know what the value of x is, we can't subtract 5 from it. So as far as GEMDAS is concerned, we can't do what's inside the parentheses. Now, you don't want to jump to addition or subtraction because there's multiplication to be done here. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and we'll distribute. Now, you have options here. You can either distribute the 4, but it's easier if you distribute the negative with the 4. So we're going to distribute the entire negative 4. That is, we're going to multiply it by x, and then we're going to multiply it by negative 5. So the 2x plus 3 is going to remain as it is. So 2x plus 3. Okay, then negative 4 times x is negative 4x, and negative 4 times negative 5. Notice how I thought of the negative here as belonging with the 5, and the negative here as belonging with the 4. And then a negative 4 times a negative 5 is positive 20. So once you've distributed, now you can combine like terms. So 2x minus 4x is negative 2x. 3 plus 20 is 23. At this stage, these terms are not like, and so we're finished. Okay, so that issue of distribution is so crucial that let's think about another situation where it arises, and we'll have another example that stems from that. So let's notice that if you have negative x minus 3, okay, this is the same thing as negative 1 multiplied by x minus 3. Now, we typically don't write the negative 1 there, but this is a useful way of thinking about it. Now, with that negative 1 there, what we then do is we distribute it over the x minus 3. So negative 1 times x, and then negative 1 times negative 3. And that's going to give negative 1x, and now negative 1 times negative 3 is positive 3. And then typically, like I was saying, we don't write the negative 1 there, so we just write negative x plus 3. Okay? So this is something that we're going to see over and over in problems. So let's go ahead and see where that appears. So let's go ahead and simplify the following expression. Okay, let's say that we had negative 2 multiplied by the quantity 3 times x minus 2 minus parentheses x plus 5. Okay, so when I look at this problem, the first thing I notice is that we have 3 sets of grouping symbols. Do you see them all? Here's one set of grouping symbols, these parentheses. Here's another set of grouping symbols, and then the brackets are a third set of grouping symbols. And what we do is we always work from the inside out. That is, I first focus on these grouping symbols, and then later on I'll focus on the brackets, which contain the innermost grouping symbols. Now, just like before, because I don't know what the value of x is, I can't take x and subtract 2. But what I can do is distribute this 3, and I can also distribute that negative 1. So let's go ahead and do that. So this negative 2 is still there, so it's going to be negative 2 times, okay, distributing the 3, I'm going to get 3x minus 6. And now distributing this, remember, this is a negative 1 like we were mentioning a moment ago. So that negative 1 gets distributed. So we get negative 1 times x, which is just written as negative x, and then negative 1 times 5, positive 5 is negative 5. Okay, so now we're going to combine like terms inside the brackets. So 3x minus x is 2x. Now this negative 2 is still on the outside there. That hasn't changed. So I can change the bracket to parentheses because I no longer have parentheses inside the brackets. And that's how it goes. When you only have one set of grouping symbols, typically people choose to write them those as simply parentheses. So 3x minus x is 2x. And let's see, negative 6 and negative 5, well, that's negative 11. And now finally, it's time to distribute this negative 2. So you don't want to distribute the negative 2 earlier because there was still work to be done inside the brackets. But now that I've completely simplified inside the brackets, which became parentheses, once this is completely simplified, now it's time to distribute that negative 2. So negative 2 times 2x is negative 4x, and negative 2 times negative 11, you see that? That's positive 22. And that's as simplified as we can make this expression in this case. And in the next video, what we'll do is we'll do some more simplification, but we'll see what happens when you have fractions involved. That's a little trickier, and it's good practice for us. All right, so see you next video.